All right, so here we are in the great outdoors in the heart of New Jersey, central New Jersey, that is, and the KIESEL guitar that I ordered is here. So I figured, let's get some daylight, even though it's a little cloudy. Let's get some daylight and let's unbox this outside. Outdoor unboxing. So, got it yesterday. I let it sit. I usually like to let guitars sit for a day just in case of, you know, temperature change, especially in the winter time. I always let the guitar come to house temperature. Right now, there's really probably not much of a need to do that, but you still never know with humidity levels. The thing's been sitting on a truck from California to here. So I usually let, when I get a guitar, you know, in the mail or, you know, delivered, I usually let it sit for a day in the house to come to house temperature. There's absolutely no science behind that. It's probably more of a, what do you call it when you just do things for no good reason? Do you have a name for it?
Superstition, I don't know.
Superstition, there you go. A little superstitious, maybe, when it comes to getting guitars. So anyway, here we go. So we have the packing slip in the box, which I'm going to put in my pocket. And then, we can see inside of the box, we have, actually, it's funny, I was just talking about humidity, because you can see over here, not only is it nicely packed, but there's this plastic wrap which keeps it, prevents it from getting to the outside elements. When I take this out, I'll show you what I mean. By the way, I'm wearing an Iron Maiden shirt today because I'm going to see Iron Maiden tonight in the Prudential Center. So can't wait to see that. So look at that, wrapped completely around here. So, you know, kind of keeps the guitar free from humidity and all that stuff. So there's that piece right there. And then, what's nice is, interestingly enough, here's another little unboxing tidbit of information for you, is that I'm pretty sure gig bags actually ship better than hard shell cases. Unless the hard shell case is on the money, which KIESEL guitars are on the money, because I've had several shipped to my house, but not every company has it on the money. If the guitar is floating around at all in a hard shell case, it could actually hurt the guitar. Gig bags are nice and they kind of hug the guitar. So in many cases, gig bags are really good to ship in. And that's what we have over here. We actually have a gig bag. I'll put this down like that. And this here is a heavy duty gig bag. This is nicely branded. If you come close, you could see even the zippers. Not only are they heavy duty, but they are branded. I like branded stuff. Branded is, it says a lot about the company and the brand and the attention to detail. So, nice padded handle, nice case, two pockets on the front, nice handle, which is actually nice to hang up your guitar if you have that option. Backpack, two shoulder straps, I should say. And even the bottom has some nice, I don't know what you call that, like feet to protect the material, so rubber pads. So that's the outside of the gig bag. And, oh man, look at that. There it is. Does that look nice? That's the Aries and KIESEL Racing Green. And this is an example of a perfect gig bag. It actually fits like a hard shell case because you can see over here, the neck is actually sitting nicely supported and nicely sitting inside. But not only is it sitting inside, they have this extra bit of padding over here, which locks right under the headstock, okay, to prevent any sort of movement. So nicely done, lots of padding, at least an inch of padding all the way around. This protects the this soft material. You know, it's funny, if this was hard, but this isn't hard at all, so there's really nothing here that would even damage the case. Same thing over here, nice and smooth, but you have the like the ballistic material always by the headstock and by the bridge. So here's the guitar. What a good looking guitar. and just a guitar that's beautifully done. I'm gonna come over here, we'll do a little, actually, let me come to you. We'll do a little bit of close-up here. So we could see over here, one, two, three, four, five, the five-piece neck. You see the stripes in the neck? Nice contoured bolt-on. String through. KIESEL branded locking tuners. And if I turn that around, the just nicely done all the way around. Their pickups, volume tone, five-way, and a head, you know, headstock looks nice. Beautifully done. And there you go. So this here is the KIESEL Aries. Oh, look at that. There's even a bevel in the headstock. Can you see that bevel right there? Nicely done. And even here, you could see here that there is a very subtle cap below the paint on top of the headstock. You see that line? See it? Isn't that nice? Just a nicely done guitar. So there it is. So I was gonna do a shootout. I am gonna do a shootout between this and the Ibanez, but of course I wanna get to know the guitar first. So I'm gonna use this in some upcoming videos, acclimate myself with the guitar, and this way I could, know what I'm talking about when I actually do my shootout video. Until I do that, I'm going to enjoy the new axe. So leave your comment below, let me know what you think, and if you like this video, subscribe for more just like it. Thank you, rock on, see you later. So here's something interesting. Perfectly in tune. And you know what that means? A lot of times when you get a guitar that is made of inferior components, you'll get bending and warping, and when the guitar shows up, it's not really in tune. This thing is perfectly in tune, which tells me it is rock solid, okay? So nicely done. Really looking forward to playing this one. There it is. Later.